Hello, darlings. My name is Willem Hopfrog Pugmire, and I am responding to this video about being queer and LDS. I was raised in the Mormon faith by my father. That's my father behind me. Where? There. He was a fisherman. He was a Mormon cowboy. He was very macho man, and having a son who was obviously gay was a torment to him. I served a mission. Most of my mission I served in Ireland, and then the latter part, for health reasons, I was transferred to the Arizona and Las Vegas mission. I came out shortly after my mission. I went through church therapy to become heterosexual. I'm happy to announce it didn't work. Hello. I love being queer. I love the lifestyle. I left the church. I was excommunicated for 25 years. And then and in those 25 years, I became extremely active in the Seattle punk rock scene, and I discovered the glory of wearing makeup and just being an outrageous exhibitionist. It was more a punk thing than a queer thing. But I have always loved being fabulous. I never enjoyed sex, and I have been celibate by my own choice since around 1985. Two missionaries knocked on my door, what, 8 years ago? A while ago. And I've always felt a connection with the elders, so I invited them to return and give me the discussions, because I wanted to see how different it was now compared to, you know, 30 whenever years ago, when I was a missionary in 1972, around there. After the third discussion, the elders challenged me to pray, and I swore to them, you know, I will never return to the church. I've strayed too far. You know, I've been a punk rocker. I've been a male prostitute. I've done all these things, and there's just no way I can come back. But I decided to pray. What the hell? So after they left, after that third discussion, I got on my knees, and I didn't know what to ask, so I asked God if he existed. I had such a tremendous, overwhelming response. It was like ice water being poured all over me. I was shivering. I began weeping. I felt the presence of my dead father and my grandfather. My grandfather was a holy, wonderful man. He went through the Salt Lake Temple with me when, just before my mission, I had my endowments. And I had my answer. I almost heard the voice of God saying, I live, the church is true, come home. So I've returned to the church as a very obviously gay Mormon. What path do I choose? Do I choose the path of being righteous, or do I choose the path of being fabulous? I'm trying to choose both those paths and walk that tightrope. I know the church is true. I love the gospel. I love the Book of Mormon. And I love being queer, so that's the life I'm trying to live. It's not easy. Being celibate helps a lot. I wish all of you, my brothers and sisters, in the faith and in the fabulous, my heartfelt wishes. Shalom.